When it comes to climate, there seem to be two opposing camps. One says, it's not too late, there's still hope. The other says, it's too late, it's over. But both sides are missing the real question. Too late? For what? For what specifically is it too late? So, on this hot summer's day, let me address that question. Who am I? I'm Professor Rupert Reed from the University of East Anglia, where I work alongside some of the world's leading climate scientists. And I was an expert reviewer for the recent IPCC reports, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. In this video, I'll start by naming some things it is too late for, and then I'll turn to the things it's not too late for. Here goes. It's too late for there to be a smooth transition. If that was going to happen, we would have had to have got serious about it a generation ago or more. It's too late, therefore, to avoid consequences, hardship, disasters. They're here. The world's weather is going somewhat haywire right now. That situation isn't going to change anytime soon. It's too late to pretend that everything is going to be fine. It's too late, therefore, to avoid the need to try to adapt to the dangerously changing world that humanity has created through burning fossil fuels like there's no tomorrow. Tragically, it's too late to stay within the safe zone. We are not going to keep below the so-called safe upper limit of 1.5 degrees centigrade of global overheat. That is clear, because the IPCC in its latest report said we would have to make deep and immediate cuts in fossil fuel use worldwide in order to stay below 1.5 degrees. And they made clear that when they said immediate, they meant starting this year. Well, check out what governments are doing this year. The UK government, the US government, not to mention the Saudi, the Russians. Crazily, they are increasing fossil fuel production and use and plans in response to the Ukraine situation. The 1.5 degrees upper limit is gone. We're out of the safe zone. It's too late to vest our hopes in that. It's too late to avoid widespread anxiety, grief, and anger at the situation. You've probably been feeling those things. That's probably why you're watching, and you are right to sometimes feel them. So, there's a lot of things it's too late for. A sobering list, a wake-up call if ever there was one. But now, look up and notice there are even more things not on the list I've just given. It's not too late to take action to limit harm. It's never too late for that. It's not too late, probably, to keep global temperature rises below 2 degrees centigrade. Reaching the 1.5 safe limit is going to be horrific and is a huge wake-up call. That wake-up call may help us stop ourselves from breaching the 2 degrees limit. For it's not too late to take collective action to adapt to what is coming, and to do so in a way that reduces the emissions and reduces the danger of what is coming. Such adaptation is called transformative adaptation. It's a huge, exciting agenda of possibilities for how we get to cope with what's coming and even to flourish through it. It's not too late to improve our quality of life in the teeth of and even by way of the climate crisis, to improve our quality of life by focusing on well-being rather than economic growth, by focusing on rebuilding community, and above all, by facing the emerging crisis together and finding our life's purpose in doing so. Now, do you notice what all the things that it's not too late for have in common? They are all about doing rather than just watching. Sitting there passively hoping, wanting a reprieve from where we're at, it's understandable, but it's not going to help. What we actually need to do together is to act. To paraphrase my young friend and colleague Greta Thunberg, when serious action begins, then hope will naturally spring up everywhere. It's too late to be a passive pessimist or a passive optimist. It's too late to be a TikTok doomer or a Pollyanna. All there is now is realism, courage, and action. So, if anyone ever says to you from now on, it's too late or it's not too late, you now have a powerful tool in your hands. Ask them directly this simple question, for what? That question takes one into the nitty-gritty that we've explored together in this video. Doing that gritty work is not always easy. It requires some courage to face up to what it is too late for. But when you've done that, then you can turn with trust and determination to the task that lies ahead of us, the great work that exists within all the things it isn't too late for. Saying, it's too late, throwing your hands up, climate doom, is a cop-out. Saying, it's not too late, we can fix this, everything's going to be okay, is a lie. Join me and a growing army of fellow humans in the space that has been opened up by the heroic efforts of Extinction Rebellion, Greta Thunberg, and millions of young people. The space of courage, of active hope. Together, we can make sure that nothing else much gets added to the list of things it's too late for. Nothing except for what we will choose to add to the list of things it's too late for, such as abject despair. It's too late to sit around moping. We need you. Join the greatest movement there has ever been in the history of this earth. Start taking action now to co-create the more beautiful world our hearts know is possible.